So today in this session, we will discuss the module 4 in continuation of the modulation processing, the topic uplink shared channel, that is frequency hopping. So first we will discuss about why we wanted to use the uplink shared channel. So this uplink shared channel is used to carry the traffic data, and here it consists of how the uplink shared channel has been mapped. Here you see it has been mapped with the logical channels, that is common control channel, dedicated control channel, dedicated traffic control channel. So this is nothing but the transport channel is mapped with the physical channel as well as the logical channels. In continuation of this, we will see the processing. There are three types of processing in the uplink shared channel. The first one is channel encoding and modulation. From this, the modulation part we have discussed in the previous session. The next is the frequency hopping, and the third is the multi antenna transmission. So here we are going to discuss the frequency hopping. So first, what is the need of frequency hopping in LTE? So here the radio communication system is getting degraded means that poor signal strength by interference, the noise and nature of the radio channel. Okay, to reduce this effect of fading and interference in the wireless communication, we are using the technique called a frequency hopping. So what this technique will do for the frequency hopping? See here, this in general, the frequency hopping technique is called as transmission technique, which will send the data with a change of carrier frequency. Okay, so particular data will be transmitted using some change in the frequency. This is called a frequency hopping. Now we have what is frequency hopping and why we wanted to use this transmission technique in the LTE. So it's very clear, no, due to noise, interference and the nature of the radio channel, our signal is going to be get interrupted. To reduce this effect, we are using the, or protect the information, we are using the frequency hopping signal. So the next, in the 3G, frequency hopping is used to provide the uplink diversity. Okay, so here we will see, I wanted to show the illustration here. Okay, here I have choose the frame, that is nothing but we have allotted the subband 0. In the subband 0, you see here one subframe. In the subframe, there is two slot, the dotted line is splitting the subframe into two slots, right? Here we are going to transmit a data in the subband 0. Here everything, the subband is consists of all data, right? Here we will take 2 to 3 types of frequency hopping, and we can analyze how the frequency changes is going to be happen. So in this illustration, we can't find any defect in the transmission, right? See here, in the subframe 1, it's same, equal, all are equal, there is no disruption or nothing is going to be happen. So for example, with a bad luck, due to some impairment, the specific frequency region will be damaged in the particular. So I will show the diagram here. So here you see, these all are the corrupted region, or the information is able to loss. Okay, here we will see, that is our bad luck. So what happened? The next thing, the particular area information is not able to be processed in a proper way. Okay, so how can we avoid this kind of issue? Okay, there is no perfect solution for this, but there are many partial solutions. So frequency hopping can be done one of those partial solution. So if the frequency changes, large portion of the data would be able to avoid the impairment, right? Suppose we are sending here, no, in the here that impairment happens, same information can be shifted to some other frequency, For example, this impairment can be avoided in the information. So for that reason, okay, I am going to use the two types of frequency hopping. One is inter subframe frequency hopping, another one is intra subframe frequency hopping. Let us see the first type thing. Okay, in the diagram I will illustrate next. See here, it is inter subframe frequency hopping. So I think in the previous slide and this slide you can see a major difference, right? So in the previous, if you go to the previous slide, see here, this is the place you the impairment happens, okay? But for the second, for the inter subframe, what we did, this frame, first frame, we have placed the information in the subband 0. Now the same information has been shifted frequency to subband 3 frequency, so that we can avoid the loss of information or fading or whatever it is, right? So here the and almost thing frame, you know, two slots constitute a single frame. So frequency hopping is happening between two sub frames, not in subframe. So if the frequency hopping happens between a sub frame, then we will call as inter sub frame, right? So the distance of are also very equal. The next category is intra sub frame. So by this we will understand that intra means what and inter means what. You'll see, this is the intra sub frame. Here you see the frequency hopping happens within a sub frame, okay? And the frequency hopping means changing the frequency, all the distance are same. You see here, subband 0 to it is shifted to subband 3, and all those things, subband 0 to subband 3. Here also subband 0 to 3, subband 0 to 3. The distance are unique. In the previous case also, inter subframe also distance maintained same. But in the third case, that is nothing but we will discuss about the third case. That is what we can, difference between the previous and this one, we can recognize in the illustration. So you notice that hopping happens within a subframe. This kind of copying is called what? Intra subframe. Next we will see the next case, that is nothing but another type of hopping. Now you may recognize, here you see, now you may recognize this is a kind of intra subframe hopping in previous pattern, but you would see that hopping distance between the one slot and another slot is not constant. It may look as if the distance is arbitrary. Is it correct or not? Right, this distance is arbitrary. See here, first subframe, so it is frequency hopping happens from subband 0 to subband 2. From subband, here you see subband 0 to subband 3. There is no equal distance, right? The distance are in a random way. That is, we call it as the random distance. Okay. So these are, now I think everybody has understand the concept of frequency hopping. The next thing is, here we are, what I have explained, it is in the point. Next we will discuss about the FH is equal to 0. Suppose there is no frequency hopping, that means uplink frequency hopping is disabled. We will mark this FH is equal to 0. Therefore, we can determine the N into physical resource block is equal to N into virtual resource block. Okay. The next, multi antenna transmission. So we were aware about that multi antenna transmission schemes we are using, we are planning to reduce the cost. And this also, it has two sections, that is transmit antenna section. And transmit antenna section can be operated in three modes: no antenna selection, as well as closed loop antenna selection, and open loop antenna selection. So by this I will conclude this topic here, and the modes of this antenna selection can be discussed in the next session. I hope that the frequency hopping techniques with the suitable illustration everyone can able to understand and distinguish the types of frequency hopping. Thank you.